Please stand. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Peace be with you. Today, we join with the Universal Church celebrate the feast day of St. Bruno. He is a wonderful person, 20-year-old, joined the community, and he has so much talent, but so humble in advising so many poor, and also be a wonderful advisor of the church in many different difficult events. Today in honoring him, and also we ask you to pray for the family who baptized their child after this Mass, and also pray for the First Communion student. We still have two more events. We have last two at St. John, and tonight and tomorrow too. And then after that, next week, we will celebrate three more events for the student who receive the sacrament of confirmation here. And so trust in God's mercy during this challenging time. And we ask God for mercy, and we say, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who made of the Abbot St. Bruno a banner consumed with zeal for your house, and a light shining and burning in your church, grant through his intercession that we may be on fire with the same spirit, and walk always as children of light through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, I will prove the holiness of my great name, profaned among the nations, in whose midst you have profaned it. Thus the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God. When in their sight I prove my holiness through you, for I will take you away from among the nations, gather you from all the foreign lands, and bring you back to your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you to cleanse you from all your impurities. And from all your idols I will cleanse you. I will give you a new heart and a place, a new spirit within you, taking from your bodies your stony hearts and giving you natural hearts. I will put my spirit within you and make you live by my statutes, careful to observe my decrees. You shall live in the land I gave your ancestors. You shall be my people, and I will be your God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial. I will pour clean water on you and wash away all your sins.
I will pour clean water on you and wash away your sins.
A clean heart create for me, O God, and a steadfast spirit renew within me. Cast me not out from your presence, and your Holy Spirit take not from me. Give me back the joy of your salvation, and I will, and a willing spirit sustain in me. I will teach transgressors your way, and sinners shall return to you. I will pour clean, for you are not pleased with sacrifices. Should I offer burnt offering, you would not accept it. My sacrifice, O God, is a contrite spirit, a heart contrite and humble, O God, you will not spurn.
To go to Manigan to anoint someone. and then combine, and then this afternoon we have first communion mass for the student at St. John of the Wood, and then back here for 7 p.m. for mass. Even this corona time and difficult, but yes, we have the blessing with the opportunity with many different ministries and provide the need. And separately and different need, we have the blessed community here always pray for us and support us, and even the challenging time and difficult, we do it in love and care. Today we hear also Jesus using continue with the parable different story and invite us to prepare for ourselves to enter into the kingdom. The place that is only that we can find joy, and only we can find that true love in that place. The parable today that invite into the wedding. You know how the wedding party and celebration, how important is that. Jesus gives the story that the king prepared the wedding for the son and invite those who come. Why they not come to the wedding? Why do they scared of the king? Or they scared of the virus? Or they scared of something? They are doing a good thing. They go to bury their loved one. They go to the farm. They go somewhere. But some way that this banquet is not important. Some way is not the priority. Like many of us, we make the decision now. The life is more important. Keeping all the regulation, directive, rule, and is important. Why? Important so we can save life. But it's not most important than be away from God. And so the banquet, Jesus wants to invite us. Saint Bernard, who is the abbess, and who's the one who gave all his life. He's so talented in so many ways. But yet, he humbled himself in serving the church and so faithful. And he's not afraid of speak up the truth. He's not afraid to bring people together for the division in the church, the separation and all things. But yet, with love, he able to do everything, and so he chose the most important for the faith he believed. So we have the choice, and I thank you for choosing to come to the Eucharist, the banquet that Jesus invited us. Yes, we come and we celebrate. But today, if we're looking into the gospel, one thing we might ask is, the person here, the man who come into the wedding, he not wear the common wedding garment, and Jesus, you know, put him away. Why? They invite everyone on the road, on the street, everyone come. Yes, probably he come and he not prepare. And probably he come and he had the chance to prepare, and he not do so. So what the reason? And so faith is also need to pay some kind of cost, you know. Being the Christian, I mentioned to the student last night at their first communion, I say you are invited, you know, today is a special day for you, receive the body of Christ. But you know you have to pay the cost. You have to come here to do that. And you have to, your parents love you and doing that and being the Christian. We need to be charitable. And many things, your body and yourself, you might not want to do it, but you have to remember. Do it in God's love and care. When you do it in God's love and care, even you are so tired, you want out, but you find the joy. Last Monday night, we have the confirmation, And everyone works so hard to welcome the Archbishop. Someone spent all day, someone spent all week worrying about this celebration. When he went over, everyone so tired. But yes, they love it. They enjoy this celebration because the spirit that really there. And so today, we ask St. Bernard through the intercession, help us so we can nurture the faith we believe and sacrifice on what we have to do to be with the Lord. And even make the choice of what we have to do. We have to do for the love of the Lord and the love of the neighbor. And sometimes we have to put the selfish behind and choose to serve the Lord in the generous way. Please stand so we offer to the Lord our prayer and our petition. Pray now that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
Amen.
We offer to your mercy, O Lord, the sacraments of unity and peace as we celebrate the memorial of the Abbot St. Bernard, a man outstanding in word and deed, who strove to bring order and concord to your church through Christ and world water. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
And
let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your Lord, through whom you make all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and wounds of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and keening for your holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured a passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection, and so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice, we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord. They may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith we proclaim. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread through all the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. to heaven with fences on our pole, pollen on our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray. That's with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph as well, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the age, we may merit to be co-heir to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the stable command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Let us pray. May the food we have received, O Lord, as we understand Bernard's work, its effect in us, so that, strengthened by his example and instructed by his teaching, we may be caught up in love of your incarnated order, who live and reigns forever and ever. Immediately after Mass and plea, we have little preparation, and we will baptize the baby, and then after that, I will put the blessing sacrament out for the adoration until 6 p.m., and then we have the Mass at 7 p.m. here. And so please pray for all the ministry of the parish. Please support the parish during this more challenging time to be charitable, to be loving and supporting, to reaching out, to serve God's people in whatever way we're able to do. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace and serve the Lord. If you don't want to stay for the baptism and for the adoration, you can leave at this time. Thanks so much. I would like to invite the family, please come.